goodness Sid made it home safely.
Stroke of good fortune, perhaps?
I hope you're right.
So do I.
Who'd be mad enough to tame such a beast? Waiting for.
Thank you.
trust me. No more shield, remember?
Too bad.
quickly, before we're cut off for good.
If it is like the others, the entrance to the inner sanctum will be at the foot of the crystal. We're almost there. Once we step onto that bridge, we'll be easy targets.
Then we better move quickly.
See any other way. cannot allow it to spread any further.
And we won't. That's better. Focus, Joshua. We're not done yet. It's over.
worked.
Don't want to know.
To them. The whole bloody army's here. Stand back, Joshua. I'm summoning Ifrit.
Stop, Clive. You mustn't. We still have a long way to go. If you tap your strength here, you'll have none left to destroy the heart.
Then you'd rather die?
Surprised to see us.
How did you?
Gav. He told us exactly where you'd be. Even sniffed out a crack in the castle wall. And when we saw the heavens come crashing down, we had no choice but to believe him. It's been quite a day.
To what do we owe this honor?
A debt I would see repaid.
Prince Dion. It's good to see you well.
So, this must be Ifrit. Your uncle bade me give you a message. Listen to your heart, and guide your steel true. Your father would expect no less. That is all.
Thank you.
For everything, Your Highness.
Dion, please.
You do realize the only thing we've freed so far is this wall from its foundations, right? Now, if your lord and ladyship's quite finished...
Well said, Gaff. We have work to do.
Don't suppose there's all I can say to make you change your mind. So I'll just tell you to stay safe. None won't take kindly to losing a best customer, especially after letting us carry all this stuff all the way to Ash.
And we wouldn't want to anger old Nan.
You mean, you'll buy summer offers? Let me show you me wares. Righto, here you go. Is there anything else you need? All done then. Whatever yous need, leave it to me. It's all done then, no.
This far without you, Torgo.
Each parting brings the hope of reunion. I missed you, Clive.
I missed you too.
If Cid were here today, I reckon he'd be proud of you, Clive.
He'd be proud of us all.
There is still much I would learn of your tale, once this day is done. Until then, all who might come between me and such knowledge shall answer to my spear.
I do not envy them.
You see, Clive, we're not alone. If we are to win the day, we must all play our part, and ours. Ours lies beyond those doors.
We've fought long and hard for this moment. Cid's dream, our dream, is within our grasp.
We need only endure this final trial, and we shall. Together.
You all know what it is that awaits us beyond this gate. And we shall face it together.
Aye.
Seems our host would rather we remain. I will stay them.
We will stay them. Go!
Just don't keep us waiting.
Thank you.
Joshua! Joshua! Wake up!
Clive, is that you? This isn't stone here.
our darkness. A rift between worlds wherein your kind might reflect.
Show yourself!
Grave and many are the sins of man. And we would have you know them. All of them. As fate has seen fit to deliver you home, consider this our welcoming gift.
It would seem we are trapped.
And the only way out is through Ultima. We find him, and we leave.
If you are to comprehend the full extent of your transgressions, we must go back to the beginning. When the world was still young, we visited upon it a miracle, magic, and in its light did all life flourish. Yet the price for this boon would prove heavy. A pall descended upon the land, painting the horizon black as night. Though we labored to forestall its spread, in this one endeavor, we stood powerless. And so we fled, that we might endure. Endure, that we might discover a means of salvation.
What if it was magic that caused the blight? What of the Mother Crystals?
I expect he'll tell us soon enough.
Salvation, alas, was not readily to be had. First, we would require a land unvisited by the stain of corruption. An unprecedented journey lay before us, one beyond the limits of our fleshly bodies. And so we cast them off. Thus, stripped to our very spirit, did we find our new paradise. A land as pure as driven snow. Valisthea. There would the true work begin. For the black crept yet behind us. And soon did we arrive at a solution. the illness having spread to every organ. There was but one escape from this fate: to start afresh.
With a new world. The one for which Barnabas labored. A paradise free from the blight where his God awaits. And where, if we only forfeit our wills and abandon everything we hold dear, humanity can join him. So, Ultima would have us follow in the footsteps of the king.
And follow we shall. For now.
Is that...
if freed, or what's left of him.
Long have our ashes lain cold for want of a spark. Cast your eyes upon them and see what you must become. Valisthea cannot endure a second claim upon her being. The avarice of man drives her ever closer to destruction. But she may yet be saved by you. It is what you were born to do. Why we nursed you and fed you, as your own mother should have. And now that you are fully grown, our Muthos, it is time at last for you to serve your purpose.
To right your wrongs. If our sin is wanting to survive, then you are as marked by it as we are. The fault is yours. Our wills were born because you abandoned us. And now, you would have us forfeit them. All for a place in your new paradise.
Do you imagine yourselves worthy of one? Mankind has no place in our world. Is this truly so difficult to comprehend? We only ever require you, Muthos, when the time comes to bid this wretched realm farewell. None shall follow, none shall remain.
What do you mean, none?
This is our world. Once the land's rebirth is complete, humanity will have served its purpose. Why would we continue to suffer that which has caused us so much vexation?
Because the land doesn't belong to you. It belongs to us all!
What?
That is where you are mistaken. You own nothing but your precious will.
Brother.
I can't do this alone.
And you don't have to.
I grow weary of your descent. Now you must learn that this master will not tolerate disobedience.
My friends, my family, we have all suffered, all fought to survive. This world may be flawed. It may be broken. But it's all we have. And if we can't share it, I see only one other choice. You have to go.
You may have created us, Ultima. It's time we lived on our own terms. This isn't your world anymore. It's ours.
Bow down, Avendus, hearts disdained.
Help me, boy.
Thank you.
slow.
Rest.
Divine Hound.
Gifted this chance, and still you would raise your hand against the Lord.
What now? The darkness bends. He means to end us.
the first time. Let's make it his last.
Your fate is inexorable. Surrender the vessel unto the darkness. Surrender it unto us. Kneel before us.
That's better.
To me, boy! Help me, boy.
past. For countless generations have we awaited this moment. Your struggles have made you strong, yet your soul remains heavy with sin. Absolution is nigh. Repent, and all shall be forgiven.
Tell me, Clive, how many lives have you saved since taking my name?
Fewer than we have ruined. Wherever we go, we leave a sea of tears in our wake.
These are the wages of your will, son.
What good are our choices when all they ever bring, all they will ever bring, is death?
There's no atoning, Clive. No matter how hard you try.
So why not leave it all behind?
Leave it all behind.
Please, won't somebody save me? Won't anybody love me?
I yearn, yet still she is not mine. Have I not given enough?
From will is born desire, and it is this which consumes you, rendering you incomplete.
Do you not see how the world bends and warps under the weight of your hungering hearts? What if it could all just go away?
Just go away.
Clive!
None of this is real. Wake up. It's time to go home, Clive.
Clive.
That's right. You're my brother.
brother.
Remember who you are.
Clive.
Once more, lest you forget.
My name is Clive. Clive Rossfield.
Look,
Ultima.
Even here, the light of the vessel's will cannot be quenched. And the Phoenix, his trespass should not have been possible. Not possible unless... unless he has been with Muthos all along. The mark of the Phoenix, emblazoned upon his heart, made manifest by the power of will alone. The power of creation. Can it be? Are there wills truly so potent?
Are you still talking?
Sorry to wake you, but I think it may be time to leave. This place...
And once again, does my creation stray from the path laid before it? Steeped in conceit, you fancy yourself a god. You embrace Logos. But we will put an end to this hubris.
What are you talking about?
In the halls of Origin, does our true power quicken? And there shall you be made complete. Soon, Muthos, soon you will discover how little you know of suffering. Crystals are no more, yet in their silence, a new song rings. Its chorus building, a crescendo as it enters its final movement, stirring those long aslumber to waking. And back to their origin.
Crystals cracked. So where the hell are they? Oh, fuck me.
Is that ether?
What in good Grieger's name is going on?
This is wrong.
Are we back?
Clyde! Joshua!
Jill! Is everyone all right?
We're fine. What happened?
Too much to explain here.
Mate! We're leaving! Now! Everyone, fall back to the ship!
I will be with you anon. Thank you.
I need to tell everyone what happened to Drake Spine. And I'm going to need Otto's help.
There's something about it.
Still alive, I see. Something tells me that eyesore on the horizon is your doing. How'd you manage that?
It's a long story. One that I'd rather only tell once.
Right. All hands on deck, then.
Is this everyone? As I'm sure you've all guessed, the crystal which now commands the eastern skies was summoned by Ultima. He called it Origin. Though the significance of that name is as yet unclear.
What does it matter what it's called? Its emergence tore Twinside asunder and wiped my homeland from the map.
Mention of the Dominion spires can be found in the oldest of Valisthian records. But to the best of my knowledge, none provide any hint as to their true nature. That they would prove the horns of some slumbering demon. Well,
the Dominion's demise was at least quick. Elsewhere, the Republican army cannot hope to contain the chaos engulfing Randalar. Canva is in flames, and the Empire.
Our allies are crying out for answers. I've sent the Cursebreakers to give them what assurances we can, but right now that amounts to fuck all.
They wouldn't be able to stop what the skies have started in any case. People here and across the realm grow sicker with every passing day.
Could it be that this new Mother Crystal is like the others? That it draws upon the land's ether? It certainly looked that way, from stone here.
If that were true, it would explain the hastening spread of the Blight since the Crystal's appearance. Would it not?
And as the land's ether slowly rises to the surface, it pools, corrupting all who cannot channel its energies. Arcay above, ether floods below, and in the middle, here we languish, hopelessly entrapped.
When we faced him at Stonehere, Ultima told us his true power quickens in the halls of Origin. Needless to say, we cannot allow that to continue. If we are to stop him, we will have to find a way into the crystal.
How are we going to manage that then? It's up in the sky. And fast as she is, the Enterprise can't fly.
It's a lot to take in, and I reckon we'd all benefit from some time to clear our heads. The answer will come to us. Don't you worry. Ain't that right, Clive?
Right. That's right.
Well, go on then. Bugger off. Same goes for you, Clive. You won't solve anything like this. Trust me. Go and get some fresh air, right?
Thank you. Joshua seemed upset.
Ultima may have created us, but he doesn't make us who we are. Only we can do that. And if he would have us fight for our survival, so be it. It's what we've been doing all along.
Much like Ultima himself, it would seem. His new world being naught but a means to survive. And so, we must contend to decide which of us shall inherit the land. Should Ultima prevail, it will mean death for us all. Of that, we can be certain. But even should he fail, what world awaits us? A withered, godless place, where our newfound freedom will most like prove a chain in itself.
Well, that may be, but a chain can always be broken. As long as one has the will to break it, it won't be easy. It may take generations, centuries of suffering. And that is if everyone plays their part. But it will happen. And when it does, it will be on our terms. That is the world that awaits us.
Indeed. And what better world could one wish for?
But first, we have to reach that crystal.
Then it's a good thing I have wings.
You can barely stand, let alone fly. And only the Founder knows what horrors await in those skies. Are you certain about this?
Am I certain? I am the Phoenix. I will do what I must. This is our fight. Remember?
All right. I yield. But only what you must, yes? I'm still your sworn shield.
That you are.
And what of my wings? Lest you forget, you go to stand against a god. I would not have you succumb to fatigue before the fight begins. Ifrit. Your brother mentioned that some few of the dominants who had lost their power to you were still able to prime. Is that true?
It is. But their icons no longer submitted to their will.
Then mine will have to be stronger. That you both might save your strength for the battle to come.
You don't have to do this.
If you do, there's a chance you might lose all you have left.
And what have I but regret? My life ended in the Dominion. I fear death no more. Besides, I would have words with Ultima. He has much to answer for.
We are in your debt, Dion.
We can speak of debts when this is over.
He speaks like a man who knows he's not coming back. Has come to terms with that.
That doesn't mean that we have to, does it, Kaif?
Time to talk to Jill. I only hope she understands.
Say your farewells, and let us be gone.
Still alive, are you? Go on, then. It'd better all be here. You'll not find a better price than that. Come again. Or don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Trouble with your gear, or... What do you want? That it? Fine.
First the skies, then the crystal. To wish on a star.
That might not be such a bad idea. This is it, Jill. You know what I have to do. Why I have to do it. There's no turning back now. This is where our journey was leading us. Where it will end, for better or worse.
I could pray to Metia for you. But you'll be all right, won't you, Clive? You always are.
I did promise we'd watch the moon together.
I'll be waiting.
It's almost time. Better make sure I haven't forgotten anything.